having a larger ensemble really allows me to have the sense of community that I think in a lot of cases nowadays is lost. When this music was in its heyday, you had larger ensembles and more places for people to work and hear each other. I think you had a stronger sense of community. Because this music is not just about the notes and the study of it, but it's very much this alive music that has a social fabric to it. And I think that's definitely something that I like with my work, you know, for this grander kind of journey. And over the years, it's evolved from some of those early influences to others where I've been more and more incorporating Middle Eastern music with jazz because I'm half Egyptian, and that's a part of my heritage that I've been looking into. And then the other is some more kind of a classical approach where you have multiple different themes, and then one is stated, a second one introduced, and then they start overlapping, and then you go on to different movements. That's a little different from the traditional jazz melody, head, form, and then solo. So it's a little more of a sprawling kind of longer form type of approach, and these things interest me that you can do with a larger ensemble and variety you have there, the different textures. You can really do a lot that you can't always do with a smaller group. In Baltimore, it's not a strong scene as far as the presence or lack thereof of venues, and so for me and a lot of colleagues, it really forces us to do more as far as trying to put things together on our own. It's forcing us as musicians to go back to a grassroots kind of approach where we're doing a lot of this stuff ourselves.